That's the thing that I mentioned at the beginning, that the intended prerequisite was two programming classes, and so you're found to be a lot of preparation, you know. But so are a lot of people. All right, if you're for Python, great. If not, please head to the other side of the lab. Make room. Would like to sit in the, you know, if you guys want to come over there, or if you want to see me, that's good. Or if you don't want to see me, that's fine too. Okay, so if you turned in a late application last time, great. Get it from me by the end of class. We need to turn it to the registrar today. I'll take the assignments at the end of class rather than, well, the copy selection. Hold off on that. Let's see. What else? Regular expressions are awesome. I actually, it was funny, I think the day, last quarter, within a week of teaching this regular expressions thing, two people had talked to me about regular expressions. A former student came back to me and said that in two separate research projects, he had used regular expressions, and he had told me that within the same week. And also my girlfriend was asking for help with regular expressions for a problem at work. So they're very useful. So let's go to the regex one, just to make sure that that's up and ready for us in 2 days. But I made another little present for notebook based on the questions from last time. Remember, if you don't know how to open up Python notebooks yet, please learn, because it's important. It'll help you review these notebooks when I post them. I also post a preparation notebook, the sorts of things, code that I type for every preparation. So if you're reviewing those, if you're having trouble with the preparation. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the questions people had and go through some of those things. The eighth lesson was, everything was mostly about regular expressions this time, so these are not really grouped or ordered, because I think that, you know, in order to get a good grasp on regular expressions, well, I mean, there's some simple things that you can learn initially, like what slash D and slash S and all that mean. But beyond that, you kind of need to look at example problems, so hopefully we'll see quite a few of those. So the eighth lesson was to try to match using optional characters, and the solution was this, and I was wondering if I could walk through the logic for that one, and if there was a way to check in the question mark in the string. So this one, I gave the answer that the tutorial does try to provide the logic, and it also states how the question mark can be detected by escaping it using this character. So some of them, if they have the answer right there, you know, ask me maybe in person, because that might get a better answer. But can somebody else walk me through this? Like, because I think this is a good opportunity for a student to try to explain how this one works. Why is this the correct solution? Anybody want to give a crack at that? Yeah.
So, first part is
that's
right, plus.
Yeah, so backslash D plus here.
Then it's like one or more, because you
have
like one, two,
three, four. Okay, so slash D, that means any digit, any number, right? And then the plus means one or more. So that's going to match 1, 2, 24. It's not going to match zero, though. But it's required to be in there here. So you have to have a number here. There has to be at least one of them. Right? Okay, what's the next part?
So the next one is just matching like files, but it's a question of one S, so it's optional.
That's right, so it has to match files, but the S has a question mark after it, so the S needs to be, could be optional. So it's definitely gonna match this file. It's also gonna match files and this files. It will match this, but because this said no, it's not a number, then it's not gonna be matched by this D, so this one is already out. And then this?
But it's just like foul, and so this is a question mark, so we'll have to put the backslash.
Yeah, this is being very explicit, the word found and the question mark character itself, as indicated by the backslash, has been escaped. So this doesn't mean that this slash is optional, like this S was optional, because it's a backslash that's escaping the question mark character. Very similar to when we write slash N, you know, or slash T in Python, that means new line character or tab. Backslashes are used as an escape character to mean this particular character or a special meta character like E. They're used in special ways in regular expressions. Cool. All right, so that's the walkthrough of that, and also answered how there's checking a question mark in this right. Thanks for that. Yeah?
Would it work without the slash D plus because, the first thing have the question mark at the end, not from the wrong?
I suppose so. They probably would. Does that, do people agree with that?
Wouldn't that work with just the back?
So first let's answer that question. Do people agree that this would work even without the D plus? It would match all three of these, and it would not match this one, I think. It wouldn't match the entirety of those things, right? And so actually somebody asked a question, this is at the very end, this is what we lost, I think it was a good philosophical question, like, why does regex1.com, for the first example, you guys might remember it, it's the only thing you saw, it's like, you just typed in ABC and it matched ABCDEF and all these other things. It requires you to only match part of the expression. If it matches any part of it and doesn't like have something that prevents it from being a match, then it's counted as a match. Go through regex1.com tutorial and try to match the entirety of the expressions that you're supposed to match. It's more of a challenge, and it means it's good to write. When you're writing regular expressions in practice, you want to write them as specific as possible to exclude things that you don't want while capturing all the things that you do want. So specific ones that capture the entire line is probably a better practice. But you're right, I think this will work without the slash D because the last one is excluded because it doesn't have the question mark at the end. What was your question? Okay.
I was going to say it would have worked with just the backslash question mark.
Yes.
Like they only have it. And
I guess you're right. The only character.
But then you said it should be specific.
Yeah. No, that's a good observation is that you could have matched all three of these with just the backslash question mark and not the last one. Yeah, absolutely. Okay, what's the main difference between these two? What would you use one over the other? And this one, again, is straight from the reference. So this was kind of leading to, I was wondering, these are the first examples I bring up. It's good, I really want to encourage you to ask questions, but I've incentivized it by giving you tickets. And so I'm wondering if sometimes people are asking questions for the sake of it. And I don't mean to, you know, belittle these questions, but I just wanted to encourage you to ask, make sure you're asking legitimate questions don't think that you can answer on your own or with a quick search on the internet or something like that so that we don't take up people's class time unnecessarily because it's hard for me to filter out the ones that you really don't understand from the ones that you do. But I felt like they went over this pretty clearly and you can test it out, you know. When does the D star work and when does the D plus work? It's right at the reference on the right of the tutorial page. It's there on every single page. It says that D star means zero or more repetitions, and D plus means one or more repetitions. So an example of that would be if you are looking for A, B, C, 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 D, E, and A, B, D, E. Okay? Let's see. Well, you could search for A, B, C, star, and if that was your regular expression, then that means that you can have zero or more C's. So it looks to me like it's going to match both of these expressions. People agree with that? Does that make sense? This will match that or that. Whereas if you have A, B, C plus, well, that requires that you have at least one C. So it's going to match this one here because it has at least one C and it has more, but it does not have a C in this one. So they are different, and that is the difference.
And type just ABC, what's that case?
If you just typed in ABC, that requires that there to be one, and I suppose it depends on if you follow that up with more stuff, right? Maybe a better, let me write it back. ABCCCDE and ABDE. I probably should have written, here's my regular expressions to match. If I want to be specific and match the entire expression, right? So I could write AB star DE. Okay? There is also the possibility of writing ABCD. That's not going to match either of them, right? This one is not going to match either of them. Because this requires that there be a D immediately after C. This one says there can be as many C's as we want, including zero C's. So both of these will match.
But you didn't write C in there at all.
I did. Oh, sorry, I went to A, B, C star, D, E.
Okay.
And then A, B, C plus D, E is only going to match that one. Yeah.
Okay, not identical to the first one? Oh, no.
No, it's not. So this one doesn't match either of them.
Oh.
Right? Because this one requires that there be a D immediately following the first C.
And then the last one says
so
what?
So zero matches?
Yeah.
This has two matches, and this has only one match.
Okay.
All three of those are different.
Gotcha.
Does that make sense? There was actually several questions about this example right here. And so investigate a little bit how it works, okay? So let's pick apart this example. So here's the regular expression that we're looking for. The brackets mean that, okay, so this is kind of a combination of things. When you have brackets, that means you're going to type inside the brackets either all the symbols that are matched or all the symbols that aren't matched. In this case, we're saying here are all the symbols that are matched. A through Z, lowercase, so all the alphabet, all the letters of the alphabet, lowercase, and all the letters of the alphabet, uppercase, will match. And we have to have at least one, but we can have as many as we want. And this is what we're capturing, okay? And then we have the space, so that's required. And then we have to have a decimal number, any number, any digit, and then we can have as many of those as we want. So we're talking about these strings here, and it looks like it's going to match them separately. We've got a sequence of letters. Yeah, sure, they're all matching. They're all letters, and then there's a space, and then there's at least one number. There's two, in fact. That's fine. It's going to match, it's going to capture two. Notice the difference between matching and capturing, right? So the capture group indicates what is going to be captured, which means maybe that's information that we're looking for, but that has to be within a larger expression that we're matching. So there's different concepts. You know, one is the piece of information that we're looking for, and we want to extract the other thing, the entire match, the context that it has to be within. All right. Okay, but the second capture group is the number. So we're capturing those two things separately. We're capturing the word June and the number 24 separately, because those are two separate things in different capture groups. And when we use the sub method here, it wants to take a look for these things, and every occurrence of this that it finds, it's going to replace it with this thing here. And this is kind of like a different sort of notation, I suppose. This is more like a normal string. This isn't exactly a regular expression, really. This is the string that you want to output. And the backslash, in this case, is being used to indicate which capture group you want to go where. So the two in this case means I want the second capture group here, which in this case is the number, and I want the first capture group that I found to be which is the word June in this case, to be afterwards. Does that make sense how that's working? So we're using the backslash numbers in this second argument of the sub function to indicate which capture groups we want where. That's the purpose of that. And so that's how it's working. It matches, it finds its first match with June 24. June and 24 are separate capture groups, and so it's going to write 24 of June, this one. August and Nimes. This is capture group one, this is capture group two. It's gonna write it in the order of nine, because two comes first of August, etc. And it actually is gonna substitute these things into the string. So it's gonna take this entire thing and replace it with this. And so I think it's gonna end up with one long string with commas in between. Yeah.
Let's say it just says due and then comma August and the rest of it. So if it excludes 24, would it return like an error?
No, I don't think so. It's just not gonna find a match there, so it's not gonna do anything with it. So let's try this, right? So, all right, yeah, so 24 of June, 9 of August. So that's a great way to do it. Let's say we just have June here. Oh, interesting, okay. So let's see, why did this happen? Why was this allowed? Oh, because, okay, it's doing a substitution on the string, okay? So it doesn't find a match there, and so it leaves it alone. That's what it's doing. It finds a match in this portion, and so it makes its replacement there. But since we're doing calling the subs function, it leaves text that isn't matched alone. Good question. Other questions about this example? Yeah, that was a good example. Okay, oops, that's supposed to be in class. So, yeah, people were confused about the use of parentheses in these expressions. So oftentimes, regex 1 tutorial would sometimes use capture groups where they weren't required. Did you notice that? Sometimes they use capture groups to capture things that they didn't ask for. And that's because they did not penalize capturing additional information. And capture groups, you might have found, can be useful, yes, as grouping. Because think about the case with the pipes. Remember the logical pipe, right? You could say, I'm looking for cat or dog. It's difficult to write this sort of thing with like, or maybe like, I want as many instances as possible of cat or dog. This is difficult to write without the parentheses. And that's why I actually mentioned that there's such a thing as non-capture groups. It's just a way of grouping things together that you want to apply a plus or a question mark after. Cat or dog could be there, maybe. That doesn't make too much sense. I think a plus is a good example of a sensible regular expression, but it's useful for grouping things. So yes, it is useful for grouping things together so that you can apply these modifiers like this afterwards to the entire thing within the group. And it went ahead and used that reason. Other regular expression engines, some in particular, can do non-capture groups, which I forget exactly the notation for it. I think it involves the parentheses and like, it's like question mark, colon. And so all this stuff inside here, it's not going to be captured, but it's grouped together for the sake of any modifiers you might want to put afterwards. Does that make sense? Yeah?
So would cat and dog be captured or not?
So let's take a look at an example. I ate the cat. Gosh. In this case, I could also have I ate the cat. I don't know if cat dog is going to be captured. So, what am I doing? All right, so pet is not going to be matched or captured. Cat is going to be captured. And cat is also going to be captured. And so the match is going to be these things. It's not going to match this. It's also going to capture these. So in this case, yeah, it's a capture group. It's going to be captured.
So even though you intend it to be used as a non-capture, it's going to be
captured. Well, sorry. If you write the non-capture expression, which it looks something like this, it's going to work like you want, but it's not going to capture it. It will match. In this case, and I don't remember if this is exactly correct, but in this case, it's going to match these things, but it's not going to capture them. Yeah, and it's useful when you just don't want to capture them because you don't want all those additional results returns, right? If you do find all, then you get these, you know, lists of all the things that were captured. Maybe you don't want those results in the list. You just wanted a way of grouping some symbols together so you can put a plus next to it. No, it's okay. It's just, I mean, it's okay. I would suggest looking into the, I don't remember the exact way for your particular engine, I guess in Python, I think it's something like this, indicate a non-capture group. I've used them before. I forget the syntax that I've used it up for class. Yeah.
Is it possible that if we do the plot outside parentheses, like cat dog, cat, cat dog?
Let's take a look. I also wanted to show you, I think it was regex.com? No. Click on the regular expression tester. So there's regular expression context. This is what I was looking for. Okay, what's your example? Cat, cat, dog? Is that what you wanted?
Yeah.
And my regular expression was cat or dog, and I wanted as many as I want. And it looks like it's, let's see, match captures only the dog portion of it. That's interesting. But it matched the entire thing. So I had to look into that a little bit further. That's a little bit confusing. When you're working with regular expressions, at least when I have in the past, I'm not a total expert, right? This is one lecture out of the whole class, so don't expect you all to be complete masters, but if you hack around for a while, I expect you to be able to get the job done, okay? That's my standard here. Being an encyclopedia of the rules or the syntax is not required, except for the quiz, you have to remember what a few symbols are, okay? And they shouldn't, they're pretty commonly used. The things that you and I would remember. People were confused about how to use the flag argument. That's not what I meant to do. There was this talked about flag argument inside the string method, since it's not using examples. Lots of people asked about the flag. Okay, so here is an example where it, I don't know if it actually showed, yeah, it didn't show the use of flags before, but it did mention that there was this flags argument. Who had a question about this? Yeah, there's a few people who are interested in this. So the find all function will take this optional flags argument. You don't have to provide it. By default, the value is zero. Flag value is zero, what does that mean? Absolutely nothing. Okay? So this regex is the same one we looked at before. This is going to find any sequence of letters and a space and any sequence of numbers. And so it finds matches here, here, and here, and it's returning all three of these. That's what find all does, is it finds all those expressions and returns them as match objects, which we can talk about later. Match objects have methods. You can look inside and see what the capture groups are, where the match is located, etc. All kinds of useful stuff. In this case, we're just using it to repeat what the matches were. We're printing them all out of the loop. Okay, so that's with flags of zero. It's doing absolutely nothing. Now look, if we ignore case, it's also not going to do anything in this case because we've written our regular expression to be case. We've been specific that we'll take any lowercase letters or any uppercase letters. But if we want to use a flag, we could have written just A B here and used this ignore case. And this A through Z basically means A through Z lowercase and A through Z uppercase are all going to be okay. So any instance where we would accept a lowercase letter, we're also going to accept an uppercase letter. Or you can think of it as like, take the entire string, make it all lowercase, and then apply a regular expression to it. So it's going to find them. Whereas if we didn't have this flag here, look, it doesn't find the J at the beginning of these anymore, or the A or the D, because those were uppercase. So it's modifying the way that the regular expression is invoked, in a sense. And all those modifiers have their own meanings. I'm not going to go through all of them, but that's how you could use it, for example. Okay, there's a question about the search function. By the way, these are functions and not methods, technically, if we want to be technical about it. So even though you see, oh, read.search, oh, it must be a method, right? Method belongs to an instance of a class, right? Well, it gets a little hairy because I think that when you import read, the re is a reference to an object that represents a module. That gets a little abstract. The point, though, is that search is really a function because we didn't, there's not, search is a function that's defined outside of a class. I bet if you were to look inside the re module, you would find that search is not defined inside the class. There's no instantiation of a class going on. There's no object here that needs to happen to use search. Or re, in this case, is just a module, or we're specifying the name. We could have imported from re, we could import search. Maybe that's the way to put it. And then it would look just like a function. Okay, so it's a function. And how do we use it here? All right, so back to this example. It says it matches at index 0, and that's where it starts, and it ends at 7, because we were looking at the start and the end function. I mentioned that matches are objects, and they have useful methods that can be used to tell you about this particular match. And so in this case, we're telling you the start and the end of it. And they were confused to use the match. That start is, what is start? I don't understand the type. Okay. I think that somebody else asked a similar question, which was basically like, why doesn't it just, I don't know, I feel like I've answered this question as written. There was a similar one later on that we'll get to the other part of it. Does that make sense what start is? It's a method, it's part of this match object. Re.search found this regex in June 24th, and it returns a match object that has methods we can use to query things about it. Where did it find it? Well, at the beginning of this thing. Starts at 0. It ends at 7. Let's maybe modify this, right? If this were part of a larger string, part of a larger string, then maybe we need to specify it a little bit, because I think that this here is going to capture all of this. So if we just want it to, let's match it. It has to start with an uppercase letter. So let's start with an uppercase letter, and then be succeeded by a few lowercase letters. That's the thing we're looking for. All right. So in this case, it finds June at 17. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. That's where it's starting out, and it's ending a few characters later, 24. So I believe that that's how start is used, find out where this regular expression is found. Okay, this was the question I was looking at. So there's a difference between capturing and matching. It matches the entire date. The entire date, part of this, oops, yeah. Whereas it only, it's capturing the two parts separately. So let's see what happens if we do this. So this doesn't capture the numeric part of the date. It only captures the beginning part. But I think that it's going to report, it still starts at 17 and ends at 24. So I think that gets at the heart of this question, which is, what's the difference between matching and capturing? This start and end method indicates where does the start and end of the match, not the start and end of a particular capture. Does that make sense? And we already went over this. Typing ABC matches all those different things. We can talk about that a little bit. Let's see. What does the group method do? All right, let's talk about the group method a little bit. still learning how to try to present with this, and so I'm sorry it's a little bit clumsy today. We might go back to the PowerPoints if you find that reading through this document together is not as helpful. But it is helpful to be able to distribute a document like this at the end with answers on it, with code that you can mess around with, et cetera. So perhaps I'll find a way to make this in a slide format instead. I also need to find a way to filter these questions, right? Because not all of them are as interesting as some of you. I feel like this the classes like last time and this time have less audience participation because you're not asking questions. I don't know if that's just the feeling I'm getting or if people are actually less engaged. So we'll have to talk about that. I'll maybe do a survey. But for right now, I'm just going to keep on with what we're doing. Okay, so let's play with this group method. In this case. So let's see what this what groups. Okay. So I know that there is a search there. So I'm going to modify this a little bit. Let's take a look at let's play around with this match object. So first of all, if we just type in match or print match, we'll find that match. Why does it keep doing that? It's a match. It's an object. Let's see what we can find out about it. Let's see match.dict, right? That'll tell us a bunch of things. Maybe a little bit two more. It has no attribute dict. That's very strange because I thought everything did. All right, well, let's type match.group and see what we find. That's a function we're going to call it. So the match.group function, I believe what it's supposed to do is equivalent to matching match.group 0. The group part of the match is starts with the entire match and then has all the captured groups in the order that it found them. So in this case, if I type group element 1, then we're going to get the first captured group, just the date part. Right? June. If I type 2, what's going to happen in that case? Is there a second capture group? Well, there's not one, so I don't think it's going to find anything. I think that's going to be out of range of some sort. There is no such group. So you're just indicating which of the capture groups you want. Group 0 is always the entire match. Group 1 is the first capture group, 2 is the second capture group, etc. And that's when we're doing subs. Remember, we refer to the capture groups as capture group 1, capture group 2, with the backslash character. So it's consistent with that. So that's the easy part. How do you define your method to access values? Let's play around with this a little bit. Okay. Ah, gosh, we keep coming back to this same example. I wish we saw a few different regular expressions. All we're seeing is slightly different Python code, but it's all going to be very similar things. And which particular function, whether you want subs, that's for substitution. Find all and find eater are similar. One is going to find them all at once. Find eater is going to go through them one at a time. What's the advantage of one over the other? Can somebody tell me an advantage of find eater going through them one at a time instead of finding them all at once?
If it finds it early, it uses less computing time to find it.
Probably, yeah. Let's say you need one right now. Yeah. You don't have to go through the entire document to find the first instance of it. Absolutely. It also takes less memory. Let's say you only need the first 10 matches. Then find eater is probably the way to go. You iterate through the first 10 of them instead of all of them. Great. I'll give you a ticket for that. You don't need tickets though. All right, so let's see. So let's play around with it. What is it going to return? It's going to return a match. Matches is an iterator. So iterator of matches. So each time you find a match and you call next on it, it's going to give you the next one. In this case, we're doing it in a for loop, so match is going to take on successive matches. And we can do all the same things with those match objects now that we did in the last example. We can call the group method, we can call start and stop, and that's how it's being used here. Somebody asked about the sub function. They asked, we already have the pattern to replace, why do we still need a parameter input serve? So they didn't understand why we needed three different things here. I think this is pretty clear if you've ever done a replacement in Microsoft Word. Search all, right? There's the entire document, which is what you're searching through. There is the first thing you type in, which is what you want to find, and the second thing is what you want to replace it with. But then the third thing is the entire document. So you definitely need three different things here. And in the sub function, the first thing is what you want to find, second is what you want to replace it with, and the third is what you're searching through and doing the replacement. I can't talk about backslash p and back referencing right now. They're beyond the scope of the class, and I have only maybe used back referencing once. It's pretty advanced regular expression stuff in the student things. Most of the time you can get around using special things like that. I think most of the other questions I saw were kind of specific, so, and I didn't get a chance to prepare much on them, so I'm gonna leave it and ask you guys if you have any other questions. All right, go ahead and you can probably guess what the password is. It's regex.
I hope you find it easy
if you did the preparation.